evaluated accordingly.
President of Court, may I? Do you wish to say something, Attorney General? As far as the translation is concerned, whatever Sonderbehandlung, special treatment, was concerned, there was no distinction, and I believe there should be. This should be translated special care, not special treatment. Judge Halevi disappeared in the translation yesterday, and there should be a distinction made in the Hebrew. This should be referred to as special care. Attorney General, this document was submitted when Kromai was questioned, and any objection or remark should have been made at the time the document was given to the witness whilst he was being questioned. The document reached our hands as part of Kromai's evidence. And it is impossible here at this stage to make remarks or to put reservations, things which were not done by the defense there and then. As far as the probative value of the document is concerned, this can be brought up in the summing up. But to request that this document be rejected is out of place because the document is part of a testimony taken at the request of the court, and there is no possibility of rejecting this document. I know of no reservation made by the counsel for the defense when he appeared and questioned Kromai in connection with his document. President of Court, a rejection could have been, an objection could have been raised at the time, and this could have been referred to this court for decision. Mr. Hausner, as far as I know, Kromai himself was not asked to remark in connection with his document, so that I believe this is not the time and not the place to make such remarks and objections.
Dr. Abbes, which passage is the one in question here?
Mr. Hausner, I believe where the special care is mentioned in the document.
Dr. Rave, it is on page 8. Is this the one?
Mr. Hausner, this is not the question. He was not asked whether the document is authentic or not. This is not the problem, as far as I understand the defense. If the document is a true copy, this was not put to Kromai at all.
Dr. Rave, do you know who it was who read it out to the witness during his interrogation?
Mr. Hausner, this is what I just asked my colleague, Mr. Bach, to find out. It is difficult to find out. Mr. Hausner, as far as I know, my representative did not have the document in his hand when he questioned Kromai, so that it is not likely that the document emanated from my office, that is from the prosecution.
President of Court, fine, thank you.
President of Court, anything more, Dr. Savatius?
Vermutlich hat der Zeuge eine solche Urkunde gehabt. Ich weiß sonst nicht, wo sie herkommt. Und sie scheint vorgelegt worden zu sein, weil dort steht, dass die Kinder über die dortigen Polenlager entsprechend weiter verschickt werden sollten. Das war für die Verteidigung günstig. Während der letzte Satz, eine besondere Fürsorge ist nicht erforderlich, wieder ungünstig ist. Es war nun so, man wusste ja nicht, dass die anderen Dokumente alle beglaubigt sind durch eine besondere Bescheinigung des Ministeriums und diese Urkunde das nicht hat. Und vermutlich hat auch niemand so viel Tschechisch gekonnt, dass er sah, dass da oben nochmal Opis steht.
Ja.
Stopp. Dr. Servatius. Honor, Mr. President of the Court,
President of Court,
this document was not submitted by the defense either. Apparently this was brought by the witness himself, otherwise I cannot imagine where it might have come from. I assume it was submitted because it says in the document, in the first part, that the children should be sent on by way of the Polish camps. This is advantageous to the defense. But then in the last paragraph, it says special care not required, and this again is detrimental to the defense. At the time, Your Honor, it was not clear that there would be a separate authentication for each and every document from the Czechoslovak Ministry of Justice. I suppose none of the parties at the interrogation knew sufficient Czechoslovak to see this word opis copy on top of the last document. שהיא חדשת. Of course, perhaps someone can help us. Opis means copy. Is that in Polish? Odpis in Polish? Mr. Hausner, yes. Odpis in Polish. How it is in Czechoslovak, I do not know.
President of God, but this is so similar. Maybe Dr. Robinson can help us here at the top, the first line.
סמל של עתיק, גם זה הכל. טוב, תודה רבה.
כן, זה גם דוקטור טבור.
אופיס is copy, and the other one is just a file marking. Dr. Hausner, I have just asked Dr. Tavor, who is the graduate of a Czechoslovak university, and he confirmed that opis indeed means copy in the Czechoslovak language.
החלטה מספר 98.
Number 98. It is not clear who presented the documented issue in the interrogation of defense witness Krumai. It may have been submitted by the witness himself. We see no evidence of any reservation made by the counsel for the defense or his representative during the interrogation. For that reason, we shall admit the document as an appendix to the Krumai testimony, without thereby making any comment as to the probative value of this document at this stage.
Ken, Dr. Savatius. Yes, Ladoni, Odd.
Dr. Savatius. Any further witnesses or documents?
Bei seiner Vernehmung auf einige Urkunden aus dem Buch von Poljakow Bezug genommen, nämlich zu der Frage der Sonderbehandlung. Da hat er ja verschiedene Sachen vorgetragen. Ja. Ich überreiche diese Stellen als Beweismittel zu den Akten.
Ken, Dr. Savatius, yes, the accused referred when questioned to a number of documents in the Poljakov book. That is, in connection with the special treatment, I beg to submit these documents in the Poljakov book to court. This is in the red edition of Poljakov, pages.
Von welcher Seite?
299 bis 302.
It is out of the book, The Third Reich and Its Servants.
President of Court, this will be marked Exhibit N108.
Ich wollte dann noch einreichen. Aus dem Band 2 der deutschen Ausgabe des Prozesses gegen die Hauptkriegsverbrecher. Und zwar die Angaben Keitels über die Judenvernichtung.
I also beg to submit out of the second volume of cases against the chief war criminals in the German, and these are the words of Keitel in regard to the liquidation and extermination of the Jews.
Und erklärt auf Befragen des Oberst Eichmann, des amerikanischen Anklägers, Folgendes.
Lahusen or Keitel?
Es fragt.
President of Court, is it Lahusen or Keitel? Lahusen, L-A-H-O-U-S-E-N.
Bei der Besprechung und was er gehört hat.
Lahusen, al divrei Keitel.
On page 494, Lahusen was questioned by Eichmann on behalf of the court and declares, then in answer to a question by President of Court, Lahusen testifies,
Mr. Hausner, I understand, sir, that if we find other passages in this testimony which shed light on these matters which the defense counsel intends to quote, then I will be permitted to make reference to this. I do not remember the entire Lahusen testimony now, and I'm not sure that all the pertinent details will be included in this passage, so I would like to have the right reserved to make reference to other sections from this testimony.
President of Court, you do not object that all the testimony by Lahusen be submitted to court. You submit this formally, the whole testimony, and then you will mark the passages you wish to stress.
Ich bin damit einverstanden. Ich habe nun diese Stelle nur hier fotokopiert. Es würde wohl genügen, wenn ich nur die anderen Seitenzahlen angebe.
Okay, okay.
I agree. I prepared photocopies only of the parts I beg to call attention and shall only mention the number of the other pages.
President, of course. Oh yes, of course, of course.
Damit das Protokoll vollkommen verständlich ist, welche genaueren Maßgaben, sagte Keitel, wären bereits vereinbart worden? Lahusen, man hatte sich nach der Darstellung des damaligen Chefs OKW bereits über das Bombardement Warschaus und über die Erschießung der von mir bezeichneten Volkskategorien und Gruppen in Polen geeinigt. Oberst Eichmann, welche waren dies? Lahusen, ja, das waren vor allem die polnische Intelligenz, Adel, Geistlichkeit und selbstverständlich die Juden. Das genügt mir.
Ulei Adoni Rozela Tete Zela Kogemanui.
President of Ford, Dr. Salatius, could you give it to the official interpreter for his use now?
Captain Eichmann asks the witness Lahusen. The question by Colonel Eichmann, to complete the record, what were the actions which were agreed upon according to Keitel at the time? The answer by Lahusen, according to the description given by the man who headed the Wehrmacht command, it was agreed at the time to bomb Warsaw and to kill by shooting certain kinds of groups and nationals already marked in Poland. Colonel Eichmann, who were they? Answered by Lahusen. These were first and foremost the Polish intelligentsia, the intellect, the clergy, and of course the Jews.
Ich möchte auch noch die nächste Frage.
The official interpreter. Did the defense attorney read any more, sir?
Oberst Eichmann. Was, wenn überhaupt etwas, wurde über eine mögliche Zusammenarbeit mit einer ukrainischen Gruppe gesagt?
Lahusen.
Ja, es wurde, und zwar vom damaligen Chef OKW, als Weitergabe einer Richtlinie, die offenbar von Ribbentrop empfangen hatte, weil er sie im Zusammenhang mit dem politischen Vorhaben des Reichsaußenministers Ribbentrop bekannt gegeben hat. Es wurde Canaris aufgetragen, in der galizischen Ukraine eine Aufstandsbewegung hervorzurufen, die die Ausrottung der Juden und Polen zum Ziel haben sollte.
Können wir zunächst noch auf die Frage haben?
Colonel Eichmann asks, what was said, if at all, about the possible cooperation with a Ukrainian group? Lahu's answer, yes. This by the man who headed the Wehrmacht at the time. He gave directives which he, it seems, received from Ribbentrop himself, because this went hand in hand with the foreign policy of Ribbentrop. And Canaris was assigned to carry out in Galician Ukraine an uprising. The aim was to scare the Jews and the Poles.
Ich beende dann mit hiermit meinen Vortrag.
With this, I conclude my words. President Court, I see that Lahuzin's testimony begins in the blue edition on page 509 in the second volume and is continued all through the third volume into the fourth. I did not come to the end yet. It is a very long testimony. In any case, I mark President of Court, the testimony begins in the second volume, all through the third. No, not all through the third, but it's concluded in the third edition, and I mark the blue edition, N-109, and those parts read by Dr. Servatius will be marked N-109A in brackets.
ובכן, דוקטור סבציוס, הבנתי מאדוני.
דוקטור סבציוס, did I understand correctly that the accused has no more witnesses or documents which he begs to submit to court or to bring before the court in his defense? Right?
Nein, das Vorbringen ist abgeschlossen.
Dr. Savatius, no, we have completed our case.
President of Court, if so, the defense completed its pleadings.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Hausner, I beg to inform, I have two proofs which I cannot bring here as rebutting evidence. I only beg to bring this information to the court, and the court may call upon the witness. Attorney General, I am not privileged to call upon this witness as a rebutting witness. The court may do so. Attorney General, I have an affidavit made by Dr. Rudolf Verba, which came to my hand only yesterday. This in connection with document number 4, our document number 4, which we tried to submit to court. This is the report about Auschwitz, written in the year 1944. President of Court, I apologize. There is something I have to complete in the court record. One moment, please.
לא הכנס שום מודל לו.
עשיתו באיזה מקום. President of Court, you were speaking about Dr. Verba's affidavit. Mr. Hausner, yes, Dr. Verba's affidavit, made on the 18th of July, 61, in London. President of Court, reached you just now, Mr. Hausner, yes, reached us just now. Dr. Verba relates his functions in Auschwitz. Amongst other things, he was also dealing with a registry, the way and the means how he arrived to the figure of victims mentioned in document number 4, which we tried to submit to court, and the defense objected. The court may recall. Dr. Verba gives all details and explains how he came to his figure and why this figure is correct. He explains how he calculated the possibility of mistakes, plus minus 10%, not more than that, as well as how he came to the sum total of Auschwitz victims. His figure is 2.5 million Auschwitz only. According to the rule of evidence, I could submit this document had it been something entirely unexpected and unknown to me. But this I do not argue, because I knew about the existence of Dr. Weber, only I tried to submit his report the way all other reports were submitted to court. There was an objection by the defense, and then it was proposed by Dr. Halevi that I refer to Dr. Weber, and these are the results of my writing to Dr. Weber. Inasmuch as it is interesting to lay down the figure of victims, and this I believe is of interest to this case, the document is important. It goes on to explain one of the documents already submitted to Nuremberg court, because the last page of our document 4 was part of a document submitted to the Nuremberg courts.
President of court, which document?
The two pages containing the calculation and how the sum total of victims was arrived at.
President of court, but now we do not have these pages as an exhibit.
No, they are not in the file of the court, but they are included in this affidavit.
In President of court, in this particular affidavit?
Yes, Your Honor.
It is an affidavit which was given to the Israeli consul in London?
Yes, Your Honor. I believe I am not permitted to ignore the document. I must inform the court that this document exists, and also call attention of the court to the jurisdiction which the court may apply and accept the document. It is paragraph 21 of Criminal Procedure, Trial Upon Information, that at any stage of the process, the court may require the submission of any evidence, and I request the court to use this jurisdiction and accept the affidavit made by Dr. Weber in evidence. This affidavit, in fact, only explains document number 4.
Herr Präsident, ich habe diese Urkunde noch nicht zur Kenntnis bekommen. Ich weiß daher nicht, was darin steht. Aber nach dem Vortrag des Herrn Generalstaatsanwalts scheint es ein wichtiges Dokument für eine historische Abteilung zu sein, aber nicht mehr für das Gericht. Ich kann dazu überhaupt nicht mehr Stellung nehmen. Ich müsste Nachforschungen anstellen. Und in diesem Augenblick des Verfahrens bitte ich, das Dokument zurückzuweisen.
Dr. Savatius, Your Honor, Mr. President of the Court, I have not yet seen this document, and therefore I do not know what it contains. However, from what the prosecutor says, this is a document of significance to a historical investigation, but not for this trial. For that reason, I cannot comment upon it, because I would have had to carry out an extensive investigation, which I cannot do at this stage. For that reason, I beg to request that this document be rejected and not admitted in evidence.
Mr. Hausner, in order to put the very facts before the court, Mr. Bach handed a copy to Dr. Savatius of this document last night. President of Court, paragraph 41 does not apply. This deals with witnesses brought before the court.
May cause any person to be brought before it as a witness. Again, but
Mr. Hausner, yes, of course, but this and paragraph 15 of the law against Nazis and their collaborators put together
Herr Präsident, es ist möglich, dass mir, wie man sagt, zwischen Tür und Angel eine Abschrift in die Hand gegeben worden ist, aber ich gar keine Zeit hatte, das durchzulesen und durchzustudieren.
Dr. Savatius, Your Honor, it is quite possible, of course, that I received this document, as one says, between the doorpost and the door, but I did not have time to study it and see what it is all about.
Herr Präsident, ich habe das Schriftstück durchgelesen jetzt. Es gibt ein Ergebnis, aber sagt nicht, wie es im Einzelnen zustande gekommen ist, in einer Weise, dass die Angaben nachprüfbar wären. Das heißt immer, er beruft sich auf seine Statistiken, aber gerade diese Statistiken sind nicht vorhanden, sodass der eigentliche Wert dieses Schriftstücks fehlt.
Dr. Servatius,
This is not directly connected with the accused, as far as I understand. This puts no new responsibility on the shoulders of the accused.